Guys, what's up? This is Excalibur. I realized as I was playing my game in server, I realized that I've been on and off recording. At some points, I haven't been able to necessarily record everything I've been doing as far as building the space. So I wanted to kind of create a little montage here of, you know, what I've done so far as the footage that I have, kind of splice it together so you can get an idea of the process of this build so far. So as you can see right now, I've got the 11 by 11 foundation completely dug down 5 layers. We're currently doing the moat right now, and you know, we're digging out the retaining wall. We're also leaving spaces for the dart traps. So there's 4 dart traps on each side of each corner. So a total of 8 traps each corner, 32 traps in total. This allows a full crossfire of darts hitting the zombies as they fall into the pit. The pit will, you know, it'll be layered in spikes as far as the moat goes, 3 layers of full iron spikes, and then these dart traps. It'll be really effective in taking out a horde as they fall into it so that they're not doing too much damage to the base, they're not doing too much damage to the spikes. So. Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, it's been a progressive build. At some points, I wasn't able to necessarily record everything, so what you're seeing now is the root of it, though. The frames above here are actually, you know, they're obviously going to come down. They're just to protect me when I'm building, so that, and then also when I'm not here, so when zombies are actually walking across it, they're not going to knock it down. So as you can see here, this is now with the dart traps. I've got a total of 8 in each corner on all 4 sides here, and then I have the 2 spiked layers. I'll add the third once I'm ready to deploy it, so that I won't need to walk around anymore after that. So I still need to wire it. I still need to put my electrical relays underneath there. That's what that space is for an electrical relay, so that I can wire it to the generators that'll be in the center, which is actually where my base will be. So there's 3 full layers of armored concrete there, and that 5x5 space is what I'm going to be trying to live out of. Not sure if I'll be able to fit everything in the 5x5 space, but that's what we're going for. So yeah, that's it. I just wanted to catch you guys up and let you see the progress so far in a little video here. Stay tuned for the next episode. Take care.